Olympic athletes, they're motivated, right? And they want that gold medal. However, they're not motivated every day. They don't wake up every day, I can't wait, go work out. But even though they're not motivated every day, they still take action anyway. So they wake up and go, ugh, I do not feel like working out. And then they put on their workout clothes and they go. How does one find motivation without any major ailments? Obviously, one of the biggest motivators people have is pain, right? If you are in pain, physically, emotionally, you can't walk or something like that, there's motivation there, right? Usually. But if you're not that sick, you've got to find motivation in some other way. So one is taking action anyway, to know that I don't feel motivated, but I'm going to do it anyway, right? That's actually how you change your lives, by the way. Whether you guys are looking to start your own business or whether you're looking to heal a disease or whether you're looking to just get abs and get fit, you have to start taking action even when you don't feel like it. Because even people who are motivated when they start, like think of Olympic athletes, all right? I always like to think of Olympic athletes because I call like my group the Health Olympics, all right? Olympic athletes, they're motivated, right? And they want that gold medal. However, they're not motivated every day. They don't wake up every day, I can't wait to go work out. I can't wait to go practice. I can't wait to drink my smoothie or whatever it is they're eating, right? They don't wake up motivated every day, but even though they're not motivated every day, they still take action anyway. So they wake up and go, ugh, I do not feel like working out. And then they put on their workout clothes and they go. So one of the ways to be successful is to take action even when you don't feel like it, to just make a decision. This is what I'm doing even when I don't feel like it. Sometimes when you go to bed at night, you might feel too tired to brush your teeth, but do you do it anyway? I hope so. Right? You're like, oh, I don't feel like this, but I got to, all right? Because I don't want my teeth to fall out. Right? Like sometimes it's just things you got to do, all right? But working on motivation is important. I mean, that's what I do every day in my group. I mean, in the first couple of weeks, I post like 3 videos a day some days just to keep people motivated so they won't quit. Right? I did a lot of that in my book, Goodbye Autoimmune Disease. I put a lot of the emotional processes I do in my group for people who can't join the group but want to try to follow along. So you can read on that as well. But you've got to find what motivates you. If it's not pain, then what is it? Is it fear of what could happen? Like, I don't have a lot of symptoms now, but if this gets worse, I may never have children, or I might get kidney failure or whatever it is. Is it that you just want a better life? Maybe try a vision board and create like what you want your life to be and realize that the only thing between you and that is your actions you're taking now. Creating motivation is not an easy thing to do or even explain. You know, my husband and I are both experts in this. He came from the business world of doing this. He's actually been on the stage with Tony Robbins many times. And what he helps people understand is the success mindset, right? So he helps people understand what holds them back from success in their lives, right? He wanted to be a successful entrepreneur. He figured out how to do that. Thanks to him being a successful entrepreneur, I was able to retire from my medical director job to follow my dream of teaching people how to heal. Right? So he's really good at success mindset. And so he coaches my group with me on helping people understand how to be successful at changing their health, because it's the same stuff, right? But it's often a daily coaching and addressing on how you're thinking. So I would find some help in that area. You know, whether it's reading books or listening to like podcasts that inspire you, or doing something as aggressive as something like my group, finding something that keeps you focused on what you're creating. And then just decide that you're going to take action even on the days you don't, until it becomes a habit, and then you don't have to fight yourself anymore.